Hello, all you beautiful people. It is America's birthday week. Happy birthday to you. I am proud to be an American. Happy birthday to my favorite country on planet Earth. I love you, America. Welcome back to the Historian's Wardrobe channel. If you have visited this channel before, welcome back. I love you. If you are new to this channel, welcome. I am so happy that you're here. I absolutely love new people and I want to be your friend. Okay. Please click subscribe below if you find anything I talk about today at all interesting and you want to hear more. I post videos every Wednesday, given we are not entering the apocalypse currently. So, stay tuned! So in this channel, sometimes I will nerd out and totally fangirl over history. So sometimes I do random history facts. Sometimes I talk about fashion history because we all know I love that, clearly. And sometimes I'll mix it up and I'll talk about something else that I'm passionate about. But let's be honest, pretty much all my hobbies and things that I love to do are all related around history. What can I say? I'm predictable. Because if you know me, you know that I'm a herstory nut. Last week I totally biffed on my bonnet, but it was fun failing. So this week for my video, I'm sort of taking a break from the ladies 1860s style look that I've been working on because, well, it's America's birthday week and I thought it would be fitting to make a video related to the American Revolutionary War. That is where we became a nation. Thank you, forefathers. But one of the biggest parts of my life in the past 3 years has been the Daughters of the American Revolution. I am a very active member in the DAR. I love it. It is an amazing society, wonderful women. So I have been working with the DAR, the National Society, and my state society. Though I am Iowa born, I am an adopted Texas daughter. I love Texas. And Texas loves Texas. So I'm super active in the Texas Society, Daughters of the American Revolution. Shout out, whoop whoop. I want to tell you a little bit about why I joined the DAR. Because I had no idea, honestly, that I had any connection in my bloodline to the American Revolution, because truthfully, I thought that all of our ancestors came a long time later. So one of my skills is doing genealogy. I love genealogy. It is such a fun puzzle, and it is so much like information and like so much that you can learn, really, and super got into it thanks to my wonderful grandmother, Nancy. Grandma really, she had done quite a bit of ancestral research into our family, on my dad's side specifically. And so I always loved the information that she would discover, and then she put together this little photo album scrapbook thing with all this information about our family. And so I was fascinated by that and inspired. And so then I just had like a million questions, and instead of, you know, trying to find other people to answer the questions, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna find these answers myself. So I started digging into my own family tree. I think that I kind of found a sense of identity as far as in the big picture of history and the past, you know, and my bloodline's connection to events, to person. I find that that is just like a deeper way of really connecting with history. So even before I had started doing my genealogical research, I had heard of the DAR before. When I was in high school, I actually had received an award from the DAR in the Iowa State Society, Daughters of the American Revolution. I received a Good Citizenship Award from them. And the Good Citizenship Award is an award that the DAR, different chapters throughout the country, they give those out each year to students who are selected by the faculty and staff at their schools. And so that was like the coolest thing for me in high school. I felt so honored to get that from the Iowa State Society. That was my first introduction to the DAR, and of course there is a depiction of the Daughters of the American Revolution in Gilmore Girls. Truthfully, the perception that we gather from things like Gilmore Girls is that the DAR is made up of a bunch of rich, old, white women, and that's not the case. The DAR is incredibly diverse, and they have so many different kinds of women from different walks of life. There are stay-at-home moms, working moms, career women, you know, they're young, old, you name it, they're in it. We have all different races, religions. The DAR does so much in their communities, their states, and in the national capacity. There are more than 1 million women since the beginning of the DAR that have joined as members, and I'm so proud to be one of those million women. And the beautiful thing about it is I found my connection to the DAR because as I was doing my genealogical research, I found out that my great-great-grandma, my great-grandma Mac, she was a member of the DAR in the state of Iowa. I had no clue that I at all would ever qualify. And so I got really into it, into kind of trying to find where that ancestral connection was. And so then I come to find out she was a member, her mom was a member. So my ancestor, who is a Revolutionary War patriot, is Naftali Guild. Naftali Guild actually enlisted in the state of Rhode Island, but he is actually from Attleboro, Massachusetts. And it is on my bucket list to get to go to Attleboro. I've never even been to the East Coast, like New England area at all. But Naftali, he actually went and enlisted in Rhode Island. He was a fifer in his regiment, and he served for the colonial cause, the rebel cause, and attaboy, he committed treason along with all of my other friends' ancestors. Woohoo! Anyway, Naftali Guild, after the revolution, he was a farmer, he was a farm boy, and he later, his family were the ones that then moved from Massachusetts to Iowa, and that's where I have my Iowa roots, and I'm proud of it. I'm talking about the DAR first because I love it. I want to spread the news about this organization because there, you know, there are a lot of people who have misconceptions about it or just really don't know. And there's a lot of ways that people can get involved in their communities and in their state to really make a difference in people's lives. I love the service aspect of the DAR, and that's one of my favorite parts of being a part of it, because we take care of our communities, our students in the schools, making masks for all of our first responders and all of the essential employees throughout our country during all the COVID-19. Super proud of all the ladies that are in our society and all the work that they've done. So I kind of wanted to make this video a tribute not only to the Daughters of the American Revolution, but also to my ancestor, my patriot ancestor, Naftali Guild, as kind of just a recognition of, you know, what he did. You know, it had to have been terrifying, though he wasn't the one carrying a gun to, you know, fight the Redcoats. He was, you know, left basically defenseless, just trying to keep the men's spirits up, playing his fife. So it's really sentimental to me, and I wanted to kind of do this in honor of him because it is 4th of July weekend, and all of our ancestors were fighting for us to have our free nation. I'm so grateful for that. I'm so grateful for the sacrifices that so many men and women did so that we can have the freedoms and liberties that we enjoy today. So in my tribute to Naftali and to the DAR, I actually had made a dress that I actually made out of a Civil War dress pattern, and then I kind of adapted it. So it actually, why I said at the beginning of this video that it's sort of related to my three-part series on 1860s fashion, the reason that it is sort of is because the dress that I made, I wanted to make something, though it would be historically correct, I could also have multi-function to this item. Today, I made a dress that I can actually use for the DAR because in the DAR, we have pages. So at our National and State Society events, we have the volunteers who work and kind of run the whole thing and make sure that everything goes according to plan and that people are where they need to be and answer all the correct questions. We are pages and we wear white. So I made a dress that I could use for my evening paging sessions, but it kind of has that historic flair to it and I can have multi-purpose. So I'm going to take pictures in that. I think it'll be really fun. And I'm going to do a whole DAR page look for the 4th of July tribute video.
You had a plenty of money in 1922. You let other women make a fool of you. Why don't you do right like some of the men do? Get out of here and get me some money.
I would seriously, I would advise and recommend anybody, if you have a connection to a patriot ancestor, go for it. It's worth it. And the friendships that you make are real. The people that you meet are genuine. And everybody has the same goal and the same purpose. And everyone just loves, we love our country. And we love people. And that's really the goal of the Daughters of the American Revolution. Okay, everyone. I hope that you enjoyed this video, that you learned something, that you liked my my paging dress that I made, and you'll get to see it again in its second use next week in my next video. And that'll be really fun for me because I worked hard on this and I like the idea that I can have multi-purpose to it and I just don't have all historical dresses, you know, stashed away and, you know, I can do multiple things. If you enjoyed this video, please click subscribe, follow. I'm on Instagram, Facebook, whatever.
Twitter.
I don't have a Twitter. And if you have any questions or please post all questions and comments and things that you would like to see in the future, below, and I would love to read them. I hope that you all have a wonderful, safe week and a wonderful 4th of July. Stay safe out there. I love you all. Thank you again. Bye! Bye.